In Adobe Camera RAW, there is this slider which is made to remove haze. And that's probably why we call it dehaze. Now, the dehaze slider can go to the right hand side. However, do keep in mind that it can also go to the left hand side. See where we are going with this? So today I'm going to show you how you can use just two sliders to create a very realistic foggy effect in Photoshop in no time. So without any further ado, let's get started. Back in the magical world of Photoshop, and if your image even has the slightest clue of a fog, this technique will work great. First of all, with the background layer selected or the image layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy. You always want to have a backup. Now, in this layer name, let's double click on the layer name and let's name it Fog. Simple. And with this layer selected, we're going to apply Camera RAW. And before applying Camera RAW, what do? We simply convert that into a smart object. So with the fog layer selected, let's go to filter and then convert for smart filters and hit OK. Why do we do this again? To be able to change the values of the camera raw or any filter that we apply later. All right. So once this has been converted into a smart object, as you can tell by the logo right here, let's go to filter and then camera raw filter. Now dehaze, if moving to the right, removes the fog. If it moves to the left, it adds the fog or the haze. So let's scroll down in the basic panel right there. Just scroll down, you will find dehaze. Let's just take it to the left. And as you do that, have a look. The fog keeps on increasing. Now I'm going to go a little over the board to show you the extreme foggy effect. You can of course dim it down. So let's go ahead and take it all the way to the left. Now the second slider, which is very important here to complement the effect, is contrast. Let's just scroll up and you will find contrast. Take it to the right hand side. I'm going to take it about at about 79-80%. That's okay. And hit okay. And you're pretty much done. Now you can go ahead and mask it out. Do whatever you want. So what I'm going to do is simply create a mask by clicking on the mask button. Now, when it comes to haze or fog, do keep in mind the closer the things are, the clearer it's going to be, and the further things are going to be foggy. Simple, right? So with the mask selected, click on the gradient tool right there. And we're going to make a gradient from black to white. Just make sure the gradient black to white is chosen and hit OK. And then we're going to make a gradient from here and go from there. Now, just the opposite happened. We didn't want that. So let's reverse the gradient by clicking on reverse. It's now black to white. So we're going to do that again. There we are. See, the closer land is clearer. And as it's getting further, it's becoming more and more foggy. And that's how fog works. Now to show off the clouds, let's take the fog away a little bit from the top. So with the mask still selected, and this time black to white will not work. You will have to use foreground to transparent. So make sure that the foreground color is black by pressing X to toggle between the foreground and the background. And then click on the gradient and this time choose foreground to transparent and hit OK. And we're going to take it from the top. Now just uncheck reverse because it was transparent to black. We didn't want that. We want black to transparent. So there we are. Let's try it one more time. That's better. And there you have it. Now, if you want less fog, you can always go ahead and decrease the opacity from here. If you want more fog, you can just double click on the camera raw filter and then just take the values to the extreme. If the values are already extreme, I'm going to show you what to do. So here's the camera raw filter. The dehaze is already extreme. The contrast is near to, you know, kind of extreme. Hit OK. Just duplicate the smart filter. No problem there. So hold the Alt key or the Option key. Click and drag the camera raw filter and drop it just above it, right there. Any fog will be doubled. It's the Harry Potter movie all over again. All you need is a color lookup table. Click on the adjustment layer icon, choose color lookup, and then let's choose night from day. There you go, the Harry Potter scene. Not quite right there, but I had a thought. But anyway, that's how you duplicate the filter. And now you can, of course, decrease the opacity accordingly. But I'm going to keep it to 1, the way it was. And then keep the opacity at 100. That was my taste. And that's how you simply add fog to your photo. I hope this tutorial made sense to you. And if it did, make sure to give us a like. And also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tips, tricks, or tutorials. And before we go, just a quick little recap. All you have to do, make a duplicate of the background layer, convert that into a smart object so that we can change the values later, and then simply apply the Camera RAW filter. Decrease the dehaze to the left-hand side and increase what? The contrast. And then you can use masks to fine-tune it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.